Hey, want to know the video content creation process from start to finish? If you do, then in this video, I want to break down the steps it takes from going from an idea to uploading a video. First, it's all about coming up with an idea. Now, I have a video that talks about how to come up with ideas easily, so watch that if you are having trouble coming up with a video idea. Now, the best way is to model your competitors and industry leaders' successful videos and add your voice on top to make a difference. As you come up with ideas, it also coincides with your content strategy. And if you watch the other video on my channel, a content strategy helps you figure out the videos that you should make to attract the target audience you want and get the conversions you're aiming for through a structured plan based on data and research. Now you can watch my content strategy video in the description below. Now once you have a content strategy, it's time to develop a creative brief. Now creative brief has the elements of a content strategy, but it's focused on the tone, look, feel, and overall creative overview of the project. Like what's the messaging and tone? What's the story and script? Who are the actors and talent? How will the set look like and how will the product be introduced? A creative brief is usually what brands send to creatives like videographers or YouTube creators so they can both understand what the overall project is about, what the expectations and deliverables are, as well as what needs to be said and shown to complete the project. You can go as deep as specifying what colors should be incorporated, what language should and shouldn't be used, or what type of props will be used on set. From there, it's time to create an outline, script, and treatment. Write an outline for how the video will be structured from intro to outro. Include key story elements and messaging. From there, you can then use that to write a script. It can be a normal film or TV script or a documentary style script with two columns. Now you can start creating a treatment or mood board using reference photos and video references to create a deck or a series of slides to illustrate the video idea visually. Now the director can start creating a shot list and storyboard. A storyboard is a graphic representation that plans the video shot sequence. You draw into different frames or squares on a piece of paper as to what you picture each shot will be. This helps the director, producers, creators, and brand see the rough look of the video. You can then start creating a shot list or a breakdown of all the shots you need in order to tell the story and say your message. Now, usually for film and TV, you would create a shot list and then categorize the shots according to your production schedule and lighting setups so that you have an effective workflow. Shooting chronologically according to your script would take up a lot of time, so plan your shots accordingly to your shot angle, camera placement, lighting setup, and schedule. You should now have enough for you or your producer to start hiring the actors, talent, and crew to execute the idea. This is the time to also start coordinating and renting the camera, lighting, and sound equipment so you can execute your vision properly. Your locations of where you're going to shoot should also be determined at this point, and permits should be in place. A location scout would be ideal so you can see the location beforehand to look for power outlets, sound issues, electricity requirements, and other factors that might hinder your shoot. All of this is according to your budget, so choose wisely. Now, if you are shooting products, this is also the time when you gather or send the products to the director or get them ready for the video. Make sure that the packaging is pristine in the way that you want it to look, and think about creating hero bottles and boxes and packaging that best represents your brand and design. Now, along with your products, you should also know your set design and your art direction and know what specific props and settings and backgrounds should be used for each shot. And now it's the fun part of shooting the video. Now, before the shoot, send out a call sheet, which is a document that has all the details of the shoot schedule to the crew, cast, and team. If you are directing or the director of photography, follow your shot list and script to stay on top of your plan. Make sure you get the most important shots first and get the most coverage so you can have enough footage for the editing room. Once you know for certain that you can capture all the necessary footage within the schedule, then try to do extra shots or unique shots to add your unique voice to the video. Remember to transfer your footage throughout the day to make sure that you have copies and reduce the time of transferring after the shoot. Now, once you've finished all days of shooting, send the footage to the editor or transfer the footage onto your hard drive. I suggest one hard drive to house your raw files and another hard drive to use for editing the footage, usually an SSD or internal HD on your computer for fast editing times. During the editing phase, use your script, creative brief, storyboard, and treatments to help you edit your video so you stick to your plan and include all the necessary elements to make the video that you plan in the first place. As you edit, you can decide to add licensed music to avoid copyright strikes, as well as stock footage to make up for any missing shots. And once you lock the picture and you're sure that you're not going to make any additional edits, it's time to adjust the color, sound, and add visual effects. hire a sound mixer to mix the sound, dialogue, voiceover, and overall audio so it's a seamless blend that sounds professional, plus they can also add sound effects. Have a colorist grade and correct the footage so it's consistent and properly balanced, while adding some unique color look to it according to your vision. Add animation, text, motion graphics, and visual effects to heighten the production value and whatever you put in the creative brief. And once all of those are done, it's time to export the aspect ratios and social media versions that you listed in the creative brief and content strategy. Remember each social media and digital platform's uploading parameters, so you have the right dimensions, resolutions, and file types and codecs to upload to the proper platforms. And once you have the videos, it's time to upload and publish where you please. And so that's the video content process in a nutshell. And there are so many different details in between, but I made this quick so you can understand the general process from start to finish. And as always, if you like this video, please like, comment, and share this with anyone you think would find this helpful. And also, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button below to get notifications. Remember, I post every single week and here to help you grow your brand with video content and learn more about video production, marketing, and content strategy. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.